In this video, I will talk about Carl Jung, who is the Swiss psychiatrist and psychoanalyst. He is the founder of the analytical psychology. Carl Jung is considered one of the most influential figures in the history of psychology. Here you see a quote from him. This quote summarizes his philosophy about human beings. He says that, "I am not what happened to me, I am what I choose to become." I will talk about his life and education shortly. He was born in Kassel, Sweden in 1875. Then, even though he was interested in anthropology, because of the economical problems, he studied medicine at the University of Basel in 1895. After he concluded his medical degree, he made an internship under Egon Bleuler at Clinic in Zurich, where he worked unconscious mind. And in 1905, he became the faculty of the University of Zurich and worked until 1913. In 1903, he got married with Emma Rauschenbach. They were married until 1955, until Emma died, and had five children. Jung died in 1961. Jung sent a copy of his book called Studies in Word Association to Freud in 1906. After reading the book, Freud invited him to visit Vienna. They closely collaborated until 1913 for 6 years. In 1913, their psychological opinions diverged. Even though Jung accepted Freud's theory about unconscious mind, he also introduced the terms called collective unconscious and archetypes. Freud didn't agree with Jung's theories and criticized them. This dissensus caused the end of their close friendship. Jung was influenced by mythology, religion, and philosophy. He didn't think that experimental science was the best way to study the unconscious mind and archetypes. He explored the relationship between religious nature and the psychology. Here is a quote from him. "It is beyond the powers of the individual, more particularly of physicians, to master the manifold domains of the mental science which should throw some light on the comparative anatomy of the mind. We need not only the work of medical psychologists, but that also of philologists, historians, folklore students, ethnologists, philosophers, theologians, pedagogues, and biologists." Jung introduced important new concepts to the psychology. One of the main concepts is collective unconscious, and it is a main view that he diverged with Freud. According to Freud, human beings are affected by their own past experiences. However, Jung also added that people are significantly affected by their ancestors' experiences, regardless of whether they went through the same things or not, and he called this as a collective unconscious. Contents of collective unconscious is known through archetypes. Archetypes are emotional images with universal meanings. They are unconscious and known through symbols. Jung believed that people react to experiences in a common way as a result of archetypes. In his travels and studies in other countries, he found that every culture has very similar symbols, and he explained this by their archetypes being common from human race. He classified a lot of archetypes. In this short video, I will only talk about the most common and well-known ones. Persona archetype comes from Latin word mask. According to Jung, it is the self that we show to other people. Persona is not only created by social norms, but it is also highly affected by collective unconscious. For example, a father can communicate with his child in a more strict way than normally he is, only in order to project the socially accepted father figure. Shadows are negative characteristics, and people usually try to hide them from the others. It is represented by images such as dragon and snake. According to Jung, in order to achieve individuation, the shadow side should be resolved. Anima denotes the feminine side of the man, and the animus denotes the masculine side of the woman. Gender development causes people to repress the characteristics of the opposite sex that exist in themselves. When the individuation happens, a person embraces the traits of the other gender within himself or herself. According to Jung, self represented the unity, combination of the opposites, such as feminine and masculine side, extrovert and introvert traits. It is achieved through integrating all sides of the personality. Mandala is the symbol of the self. He argued that every human being should achieve self-actualization, which is called selfhood by him. It is a quote of him about the mandala. He says that, "I had to abandon the idea of the superordinate position of the ego. I saw that everything, all paths I had been following, all steps I had taken were leading back to a single point, namely to the midpoint. It became increasingly plain to me that the mandala is the center. It is the exponent of all paths. It is the path to the center, to individuation. I knew that in finding the mandala as an expression of the self, I had attained what was for me the ultimate." He saw the individuation, which is like a self-actualization, as a human being's ultimate goal. And in order to achieve it, one should not repress the shadow side and integrate it to the true self. It can also be seen as balancing the conscious and the unconscious, which will create a harmony, happiness, and calmness in a self. He explained introvert and extrovert concepts in a psychological way. He argued that every person is either introvert or extrovert due to their personality type. According to Jung, introverts focus on their inner world and dreams. They might be less engaged in social activities. They are usually insightful and thoughtful. On the other hand, extroverts are interested in engaging in social activities. They are more focused on their outer world than inner. They are active, energetic, and social. He made significant contributions to dream analysis. Instead of focusing on the events and the people in the dreams, he interpreted the dreams through the symbols, which are the part of collective unconscious. And by giving meanings to these symbols, they come to consciousness level and unite the contrast in the self. These symbols also have a role to connect human beings to the spiritual life. He published many books. The Red Book is probably the most famous book of him. When he was 38, he started to hear some voices and see images. It made him to think that he had a psychosis. He saw this experience as a confrontation with his unconscious mind and recorded every detail about his experiences. This book is the combination of his written notes about that process. In his Psychology and Alchemy book, he talks about the theory of individuation and the role of alchemies in psychoanalytic process. He also wrote books that are unrelated to psychology. His book, Flying Saucers, is about the importance of UFO sightseeings. Also, many books, movies, and songs were inspired by his life and work. For example, famous movie director Fellini used his dream analysis in his movies. Another well-known director, Kubrick, used the theme about contrast of humans in his Full Metal Jacket movie.